So we are, let me see for today, the week one of web technology. Under the week one, the aim of the week one is designing the static pages for online bookstore web application. Not only for online bookstore, we can design for any type of web applications which look like similar to this static pages which has showing here. Under this week one, we have three sub pages we need to design. The first one is the home page. The second is the catalog page. The third is the catalog page, how it looks like. The difference between the first home page and this page is we are talking about the catalogs where in the this area we are displaying the catalogs. The third program under the week one is registration page, which consisting of the following fields like first name, last name, gender, DOB, date of birth, username, password, confirm password, address, postal code, mobile number, email ID. In last week, we have seen how we are designing this homepage. Just for a recall, let me see what actually this page consisting. A page actually consisting of a set of web pages again. Now, how this page has designed means here a page can be divided into parts. Each part is called as a frame. Now this is one part, this is another part, and this is another part. Now under this we have three parts. So part is also be called as frame. So we have three frames under this. Already in the last lab, we have completed the frame one and frame two. So these are the two frames. This is not two frames. We have completed main program, main.html, as well as frame one.html. So in frame one, what we have designed, we have considered a table which look like as a two rows. In the first row, first column, we have a logo. The second column of first row is the name of the bookstore. The second row, first column is home. Second column, latest arrivals. Third column of the second row, bestsellers. Fourth column, contact us. Fifth column of the second row is search. This is what we have completed in the last week. Let me see in this week how we are going to designing frame two and how we are designing frame three, as well as the catalog page and registration page. Okay. Now here, I'm just opening the week one program. What we have discussed in the last week. This is main.html. What we have done in the main.html, we have taken the two rows. The first row talking about the 20%, the rest will be star. So in the first row, we are adding what? This frame1.html. This is frame one name. Again, for the second row, what we are doing? Again, we are dividing into a frame set columns, like 20% is one column, the rest is goes to star. So in this one, in the next of 20%, this is a 20% of the column. In this column, we are called as frame two. What we are keeping under that? F2.html. Again, we have a star here, right? In this calls equal to. For this star, we are adding frame three with the help of frame3.html. Now, how many pages we have seen last lab? Main.html. This is entire program is main.html. Now, F1 also we have seen. That is F1.html. Now, how many pages we need to be completed for complete of the home page? Only home page. I'm not talking about, again, how many pages is required for F1, how many pages is required for F2, how many pages is required for 3. That is another secondary part. Now, for designing the home page only, we have already completed F1.html. Now, we'll see F2.html. This is F2.html. What we need to add in the F2.html? We need to be add what the output look like in the F2.html. This is F2.html, right? In this F2.html, we need to be add a four links, hyperlinks, computer, electronics, electrical, biotech. This has to be fit in this frame two. Okay, let me see that. So this is frame2.html. And if you are not comfortable with these styles, no worries. When we start the second unit, at that time, again, we have a second week goes to CSS only. So if you are comfortable, this is a external file is required. If you are not comfortable, once I am sharing this program to you, if you are not comfortable with this line, you just put it in a comment or remove it for time being. If you are comfortable with this, already we have discussed a style called as boy. Boy is a class of style over here. So this boy is a class. How we are saying this is a boy's class style? If you are starting is a dot, it is a class. If you are using hash, it is a ID style. So in this one, what we are doing, the background image. So this is my path. If you don't have your, if you have your own image, you please mention that your image over here. Okay. So we are just repeating this image for Y times. Background repeat. Background repeat means the same image will be repeated for if any number of times if you require with the 50-50 pixels. 50 pixel, one image. Again, 50 pixel, same image. Again, 50 pixel, like this. The size of the frame will be divided like that. If you want, you can use this one. If you are all not comfortable for time being, then you please remove from here, link to up to this. If you are not comfortable. If you are comfortable, you can please try to do it. It's a very simple, nothing to worry. Next, let's start the body. So for this body, we are applying a class called as boy, which is apply for this image with repeating of 50 pixels. 50 pixels means what? This is the entire frame. Is a notepad or a page, is an entire page. Each page divided is a 50 pixel. First 50 pixel goes to this image. Again, next 50 pixel. How much the size of the page? That many, the size of the page divided by 50, how many number of images will come? That many number of same image will be repeated. Okay. So we are inserting a table with a border of left because the frame is where? The left side. The total home page will be in the left side of that, right? So align is left. What we are adding? We are adding a computers is one link, second column, that is second row in the first row, first column. This is first row, first column. See, this is first row, first column. What we are adding? A computer link we are adding over here, a computer. When you are clicking this computer, where it has to display? All things has to display at target is what? Frame 3. Agree? So frame 3 is the target to display for that. Now computer.html is the program. It needs to be designed for this. So whenever click the computers, it has to be targeted. It has to display computer.html file in F3 frame. And similarly, we have another second row. In the second row, first column, we are adding electronics. In the third row, first column, electrical. Fourth row, first column, biotech. Like this, the entire table has to complete it and the body is completed, right? So simply we are considering a table consisting of a sum four rows we required. Computer is one row, electronics is another row, electrical another row, biotech is another row. All should only require one column. So first row, first column, computer. Second row, first column, electronics. Third row, first column, electrical. Fourth row, first column, biotech. The respective pages is required for here. Now, tell me how many, if you have V4 Yadav, Vikash Yadav. Vikash Yadav, are you there? Now, here the total consisting of computer.html, electrical.html, electronics, electrical, biotech. And remember, how many HTML pages is required for here? We require totally 4 different HTML files are required. For computer, 1 HTML file required. For electronics, 1, electrical, 1, biotech is another, right? So just I am save this program. Already it is saved as just for your convenience. Save this program, all files, f1.html. Enter. So already file is there. Just I am running F2. So if you run only F2, what will happen? If you run only F2, what will happen? It will just only show you that output as like this. This is the output you look like. This is, but where we have to run every time, where the reflection has to done? At main.html. Clear? So we have to reflect this at main.html. Don't forget that. So I'm just running main.html. So already we have mentioned in main.html, what we have mentioned in main.html, here in frame 3, in this is a frame 2, right? In frame 2, what is the file name? When I'm clicking this frame 2, this is a frame 2. So f2.html has to run. So I'm running the main program. main.html. So hope all you are seeing this. So this is the first frame. This is the second frame. Because already I have added the rest of the frames as well. That's why it is showing the frame 3 as well. Okay. So for time being, what I can do is I just put it in. Right. See, only frame 2. So this is already have completed. So if you want to just add a logo so that you can comfortable. Just I'm downloading Dhanikirtan logo. Anything, anyone logo. Where is our programs is here. I'm just saving that program, this image. Okay. Now, in main.html, that is for F1. In F1 only, right? The logo has to insert it. Just give the path where your logo look like. So here, this is the logo. Right, agree? Now just mention the path. Where is that logo? Here is the logo. Here is the logo. Just replace the path. Just replace the path over here. Just. Here it is. Here. Now slash. What is the name of the image? It's Sri Vidyaniketan. This is .png. .png. Okay. Just save. And if you run the main.html, here, see the logo? It come. Because 50-50 pixels, what I have given here, width and height is 50-50. So that's why you please make sure in this one, you can increase. You want, you can increase to 150 so that you can little bit of size is more. Okay, so but as part of this is more, so better to go for 75. So as per your requirement, you please change the 75. It is comfortable, right? So this is how we can add it. And here the frame 2, just now we had designed this, a table consisting of 4 rows and each row consisting of 1 column. When I click computer, how many files here? How many files we required here is computers.html, electronics.html, electrical.html, bytec.html. These are the 4 pages. So again, you have to be designed. Okay. So that is the second frame we have completed. Now coming to the third frame. We have a third frame, right? Here is the third frame where how we can we do this, the third frame. In this third frame, how we are designing is I will go for frame 3. In this frame 3, what is the output we require in the frame 3? We have required a box. Here, this is one division. This is another division, the rest of the another division. It consisting of a solid dashed box with some description, a 2 text fields, username, password, and a 1 button, sign in button. And there is a 1 label, new users, and followed by create an account. So this is the things we had to be add in f3.html. Let me see that also. Now here again I am saying this is one for a paragraph we are applying a style. Here we are applying a style. What type of style we are applying? This is a p.le in the sense p is a paragraph tag. Only whenever you are using in the body of the HTML, wherever you are using paragraph tag, this style will be applied. Whenever you are using paragraph tag in your the body of the HTML, automatically for that this style will be applied. What is the style? Font style is a italic. Font weight is 600. We are applying for that. Only for paragraph. Because why for only paragraph? We are using p.le. If you want to use for any anchor tag, you can use a.le. If you want to use for an image, img. Not le. Le is a user defined. Anything you can define. Okay. So for body, what the background color we are using? Cyan. If you want, you can change that. This is the style we are adding in the head. Okay. Again, I am saying this is external CSS. If you want, you can add it, or else you can just remove this line and you can do your thing. But when we are discussing unit 2 and week 2, then you can know about all these things. Now coming to the body. In the body, what we have seen, what we need to do, a divisions, right? So how we are doing that divisions are, here I am considering a division. How the division look like? How the division style? Style equal to, what is the style here? The division, a border consisting of a hyphens, that is dashed lines will be there. Of what size? Based on that size, we can define it. The same we are defining in style. Where it is coming? Left side or right side? In the frame 3. In the frame 3, this is the frame 3, right? So this in the frame 3, where it is coming? These are the two boxes are there, two divisions are there. This is left division. This is totally right. Now we are doing that as left, that is margin left 50 pixels. Border how much? The border is 2 pixels. 2 pixels means the thickness of that. Dashed black. Which color we are there? Dashed black. If you want blue color, dash blue. So 2 pixel is one value. And second value, how we are representing? Space dashed. Third value, space black. Now what is the width and height you are giving? Width and height means what? Size of the box. The width and height of this. 700 pixel by 500 pixel. And float. Float talks about where it has to be displayed. The total box, where it has to display. Floating towards left. Okay. So these are the some of the declarations. Margin left, border, the width, height, and float. This is a box we have designed. Now, this is one first box is completed. Come to the second box. This is another box is there, right? This is another box. Now for that, see the code, how we have written. So table, the border width is 100%, aligned with center. Aligned with center means what? Here, we are making that box as a, the rest of the border, width of 100%, aligned with center. Now here, before going to the second box, please make sure that how many things or default what we are saying in this aim, what they're saying in this one, the home page here already they given it, the description they given it. In the home page, we are representing, if you see the description here, the description, what's the default matter here inside the box? It should be the description of the bookstore, which may consist a images, scroll text, or anything we can consider over here. Now this description of this total is a default, should be there. Whenever you are running the main.html, automatically the description has to be displayed over there. Now what is the size of the description you can give over there? Already have defined width and height of the particular box. Agree, no doubt. But how much of lines, how much of things I can be occupied? It depends on, like parallelly there is one box. Again, there is another box you are designing. This is another box, right? Based on this box size, automatically the text also, the box also be need to be fit as per this box size. Now, how we can decide the size of this is, how many rows are there here in this box? Username is one row. Password is another row. Sign in is another row. User, new user is another row. Create an account is another row. Totally how many? 5 rows are there. So based on that, I am going to be designing the text or description inside the division of this dashed black lines of this box. 5 rows of text I am going to be inserting over there, because I have parallelly a box, another division is there, which consisting of approximately 5 rows. Clear? Now, in the same fashion, see here, the table we are inserting with width and this 100% and aligning center. Now, row. So row, we are going to merging row span equal to 5. Why you are using this column? You are in this first row, first column, you are inserting row span equal to 5 means, already I said you, here, totally 5 rows are there. That's why I am merging this entire. This is merging, right? This has to merge total as per the parallel of this one. So I am merging that total into 5, row span equal to 5, align center, class equal to border. So what we have written in the border, class already we have defined the border in W1 dot, this is in new1.css, there is a class called as border. That's why from directly we are importing that one. If you are not understanding that, doesn't matter. Class equal to here border or border, there is a spelling mistake, border we are using over there. Okay, now I am giving here description of the bookstore. Hello friends, so and so, you are viewing so and so, blah blah. You can add some your own description of your own website, of your own bookstore. You can describe whatever you like to be. Here just they are describing a tight bookstore's web page, like consisting of electronic books, electrical books, computers books, biotech books, all things. If you want, you please right click, go see on the right hand side, you please click on. If you don't have registration, you please sign up. Some type of information they are describing over here. So this is end of the division and end of the table, end of the division. Okay. So end of the table, end of the division. So this is entire division belongs to for this box. Clear. Now coming to the next box, what we have. Again, we are considering one more division. One more division where the margin right, this is previously it is a left one box. Now it is a margin is right is 50 pixel. Border is a 2 pixel. That is a dash. Now it is a what? Here is a solid. This is a box total is a solid line. So solid, you can use black color or any. So I am using blue color, solid blue. Width is 300 pixel, height is 400. Because the only small, right? Width is 300, height is 400 pixels. Float, previously float becomes left. Now it is a right side. Float is right. So this is one division we are considering. Again, the same. How many rows are there? 5 rows. How many columns in each row? Only one column. So I am considering first a table, align center, border 0, and cell spacing. Cell spacing, already we have discussed yesterday. Spacing between the first field, first column, second column. That is cell spacing, right? Cell spacing is 40 I am giving. You can use anything, 40 or 50, 30, it is your interest. I am creating first row. What will be there in the first row? Align center, we are inserting a column. What type of column I am inserting here? Username is a text field, password is a text field, right? So I am inserting a text input. How you are inserting input text? Input tag, type equal to what? It's a text, I am just giving a value. What's the value there? Username. Value means where it display? It display inside the text field. If you want to display inside the text field, you can use value equal to. If you want beside this, if you want to display, you have to be write that in between the input starting tag and ending tag here. In this place, if you return after this, if you return here username, it display as a label. If you return in value equal to username means it will be display the text inside the text field. Hope you are observe some of the when you are filling registration form, they will say you what to fill up in that one. In the hidden text, they will be use that. And align is center over here. This is first row. The second row talks about input type equal to password, value equal to password. What is the third row here? The third row is sign in button. Fourth row, a label, username. Fifth row, a button, create an account. So third row talks about, here this is the third row, talks about a button, whatever button, what is the name of the button? Sign in button. Now what is the fourth row? Is a just a label, you can use a column, new user. Next, what is the last row? This is last row, create an account. So when you click on that one, when you click on sign in, what will happen, the action, here we are not writing. When you click on the create an account, what should be reflected? It has to reflected the registration.html. Because when you don't have any account, when you are sign up or when you are creating a new account, what details there are? In 1C, we have registration form, which consisting of first name, last name, your password, verify password, date of birth, the age, or blah, blah, things we can ask in that registration form. So when I'm clicking create an account, it automatically opens a registration form, which will be reflected, navigated to registration.html, right? So this is another division. So end of the table, end of the division, end of the body, end of the HTML. So this is one division here you are considering. Here up to this. Here up to this. This is one division. Right division. This is talks about. This is another division. First division. Okay. So in this program, how many HTML files we are required in this for this frame 3? We required only one HTML page, that is registration.html. This is one file is required. So just save this program. All files f3.html. So already file is there, so that's why I'm replacing. So if you run only f3, what will happen? It display only like this. This is the how we have devised with the description we have given, and this is a one border. So this is one division with the dashed lines with the black color. This is another division with the solid blue color. So here first row username, second row password, here sign in button. Username is just a label, create an account. If you click on create an account, it has reflected on registration.html. Clear? Now already this is a frame 3. I am already also added. Oh shit! Already added in frame 3. This is frame 3. This is main.html. In this main.html, already I am added as f3 here. So in the f3, what it is displaying? f3.html. So we have just now designed f3.html. Just run the main program. So this is main program. I'm just refreshing. So see. Once you refresh it in F3, this is F3, right? In this F3, whatever you have just now designed it, this is the two divisions you have designed. So still you can reduce the sizes so that equally can make sure. Here also you can reduce the frame sizes so that exact fitness is there. Because if you divide more, see, it will gone to the bottom. See the second division, it goes to the bottom. So that's why. Make sure the percentages of rows and columns will be has very comfortable, and you please make sure add little bit of you can give more spaces over here. You can increase the font size of these links so that it should be occupy more space over there. And if you are here also in the top also, if you are increasing more image size, means it will be comes down. So please make sure that the title also look like in the form of an image instead of a text. You can add a image also over here. Okay, so this is about 1A homepage. So what we have designed in 1A homepage, we have designed main.html for entire program, f1.html, f2.html, f3.html. Now totally 3 frames we are having, so that's why we are created 3 different HTML pages and one main HTML page which connects all these 3 pages, f1, f2, f3. This all 3 will be connected as main.html. This is for our naming convention. This is for our understanding. We are adding over here. Clear? Now, how many pages you'll actually design? Now, 1A is not completed here. You had to be design your own pages. Which pages? How many pages in f1.html? You need to design home.html, latestarrivals.html, bestsellers.html, contact.us.html, search.html. Now how it look like home.html, it depends on you. This is the home page, for example. The same look like as a F3. If you are want a new page, when you are clicking home, means what? Nothing has displaying because you're not designed till now home.html. When I click latest arrival, it doesn't display anything because still now you're not designed latest.arrivals. When I click bestseller, it is not designed. So that's why it is showing error. Okay. So how the home page look like is your interest. How latest arrivals will look like. Normally, how the latest arrivals look like? You can take a table, you can add the latest arrivals in computer sciences this or in electronic this or like this. You can design in your own style based on the knowledge, whatever you get it, or based on the information or based on the experience you have, based on the browsing, you can design your own latest arrival pages. One page. Bestseller, who is the bestseller? You can just give the publisher details. Publisher details, how you are giving, how you are designing, like in the form of a table, like publisher, Welly, who is the details, Springer publisher, what is the details, or Pearson, what is the details, their phone number, address, or how you can best design further. Contact us means your contact, like how your already we have an address tag or different tags are there. You can use that tags, HTML tags, you can represent as per your style. Search means just you can insert a text field, add, or you can, once you click the search, you can reflect the Google page itself. You can reflect in this frame 3, the Google page itself, how the Google page look like, the logo of the Google followed by a text field, followed by a search button. Like this, you can add in the bottom. Like however you can design, that's not a matter. That's your interest. This is your own interest, how you best you can be do it. And here again, totally how many pages in your phone? Home, latest arrival, best sellers, contact us, search. 5 pages are required. And what about F2? Computers.html, electronics.html, electrical.html, bytec.html. How many? 5 plus 4. That is 9 pages is required. In F3, how many pages we required? Only one page, that is create an account, registration.html. When you're clicking create an account, it has to open registration.html. So this is one page. So for completion of 1A, what your task is, you had to design 10 pages. This is for frame 1, 5 pages. For frame 2, 4 pages. For frame 3, 1 page. So for all frame 1, it is totally 5 pages is your own interest. But in the F2 for catalog, this is a catalog, right? So in 1B, they have given the style, how the catalog look like. For example, for a computer. So already I have designed for a computer catalog. If you want, you can just see here, the catalog. Here I already have designed how the catalog page look like. If you see the catalog page, what are the details in the catalog? Snapshot of the cover page, title of the test book, author name, publisher, price, and more details linked. So these are the 6 fields has to be added in catalog page. So let me see 1B program catalog page. How it look like the catalog page? It should consisting of a cover page, and we have a details like the title, the publisher details, the cost, and more details. This is another link. How we are designing here? We can take a table consisting of a one row having 3 different columns. First column, a cover page. Second column, the details of book. Third column, more details. More details in the sense, their website, you can make a hyperlink in the more details. Like this, second row, again, in the first column, this cover page, second column, details, third column, more details. Like this, you can design the catalog page for computers. Similarly, you have to design electronics.html catalog. Look like as same, a 2 or 3 textbooks cover pages with their details. When you click electronic, 2 or 3 textbooks details in electronic.html. Similarly for biotech. Now for an example, let me see computer.html. For your understanding, I'm just giving you a simple example how the computers.html look like. This is background color. I'm using red over here. As I said you, I'm using a table, border, width, and cell padding. Cell padding means what? The sizes of the cell. Is cell padding is 5 I'm giving more because I need to insert the cover page, the details total. 5 you can be take consider because another way you can ask, this is the 5 lines. You can use the padding also. Cell padding equal to 5. Okay, so cell spacing is between cell to cell, the space is 5. Now in the first row, what I'm adding a cover page. This is first row, first column. This is first row, first column. In the first column, what I'm adding? An image. This is the first column, image. In the second column, what I'm adding? HTML book details. I'm just using break. Break in the sense, it will cut to the next line. Solution, publishers, cost, up to this. So this is the second column. In the third column, what I'm adding? A more details. What I'm hyperlinking? Here in the HTML, you can use the any website link of this particular publisher. For example, Dream Tech Press, which is we are following for the first unit. This is HTML5 black book, which we are following for that. You can view that website link over here. So this is first row. Up to this is a first row, right? So first row consisting of 3 columns, cover page, details of the books, followed by more details. Now in the second row, same. This is a second row. First column is here. See, this is a second row entire. Second row, first column, image. Second column, the details of the books. Third column, more details. So you can design your own for more details, own web page. Instead of that, what I'm suggest you is, you please make sure when I'm clicking more details, it will be reflected to the next navigated or website. Okay. So end of the table, end of the body. So this computers.html belongs to which frame? Computers.html belongs to which frame? F2. So you have to be see such a way that in F2, whether the same path, wherever you have placed the computer.html, the same path, whether we have reflected in F2 or not, please cross check that one. So where it is the computers, where is the computer link here? This is the computer link in this row. So in this row, see such a that this computers, when I'm clicking computers in frame 2, this is F2.html file. In this one, when I'm clicking this one, where I kept it computer.html? In C, local drive E, KKBashi, WTSV16, demos, week 1. Here my file is there. That path you have to mention here. So when I click computers, where it has to display the target? Frame 3. So that's the same. Frame 3 will be reflected over there. Just see how the output looks like. So this is the page. Now already I have saved the computer.html. When I'm clicking computer.html. When I click computer.html, the background color is red because I don't have images. That's why it is showing error over here. So this is the details of the book and details of the PHP book. This is a HTML5 book. When I click more.html, if you are linked with the hyperlink with any website of this publisher website, it will open that one. So still we don't have connected. That's why it is showing error. Okay. Similarly, when I click electronics.html catalog, we have to display electronics.html and make sure that in this path, you have to change. In this, you have to change. In electronics, wherever you put the electronics.html, that path has to mention. Similarly, electrical.html. Similarly, bitech.html. Okay. So like this, you can add your respective 4 pages over here. So for home and everything is, you have to talk about frame 1. In frame 1, already we have inserted home, the latest arrivals, all. So here, wherever you are keeping the home.html, this is when I'm clicking home, where it is, what it has displaying? See, f3.html, because for home, I've just initially when I'm running main.html, it looks like the description, the username, password, sign in, sign up, or create an account details. So that's why I connected directly this path. Just it is connecting to this one. So for that, what you can do is, where is the F3? In this path, F3 is there. So I'll just correct it. See, I just copy the path. This is the entire path. So F3 is there. When I'm clicking home, I'll just refresh. When I click home, just see, when you are opening home, automatically the page will look like the same. When I'm clicking home, it also look the same because when I click latest arrival, it display error page because I didn't connect that. So when I click home, automatically f3.html page will be open. When I refresh the page, automatically the f3.html only be displayed. So for both, I'm just using same file. So similarly, when you have design latest arrivals, make sure where it latest arrival is available, you please copy paste that HTML file here, that link path. So always the target is F3, don't forget it. Bestsellers, again mention the path here. Contact us, mention the path. Search, mention the path. Clear. So that is for one example I have shown you in the catalog. Now coming to the 1C. In 1C, what will be there? In 1C, first week 1C, registration page. How we had to design the registration page? Pages can, forms, with the help of forms, we can use this registration. So this is a one form, right? Sign up is a one form. Sign in is a one form. In the form, we have some set of elements belongs to form. What are the fields in the form? First name, last name, gender, date of birth, username, password, confirm password, address, postal code, mobile number, email ID. All this will be available there. So I already have designed registration.html. Just let me see how the registration page will look like. So see, registration page. Now registration page is your interest. They had not mentioned any style. They didn't mention any style. But my registration page looks like this. I'll just run only the registration page. Hope it is visible to you. See, the background color is a pink. Here I'm using a dashed dots consisting of a details like the title of the form, the first name, last name, gender, date of birth. First name is a one text field. Last name is one text field. Gender, we have 2 radio buttons. Type equal to, when you are using input type equal to text means text field. When you are using input type equal to password means it's a password. When you are using input type equal to radio means automatically radio buttons will be created. So date of birth directly you can take calendar. So there is a element we have, HTML element, directly you can display the calendar like this. And username is another text field. Password, type equal to password, confirm password is again type equal to password, address is a text area, right? So postal address is a text field and email ID is a text field. And we have a last, we have two buttons, reset button and submit button. So like this, the registration page look like. Now see the code, how it will look like. So what initially we had doing, background color pink, BG color, body background color is pink. We are using this one. And I am using a division. What is the division totally I am using? A total margin left, totally the division, border 2 pixels, dashed with red color, width and height is the total size. The width is 400. The total height of the registration page I am considering is 621 pixel. Float towards left. I am using towards left for that. And again in this division, I am inserting a table. So inserting a table again, nothing but what? How many rows we required? How many number of fields you are going to be adding? That many number of rows, that many number of columns you like to be, right? So that's why I'm using a table, center, width and border, cell spacing, cell padding is 3 and 5. Now I'm just using a header, heading for this one. Heading for the table is fill details for account creation. This is the heading I'm using. So it is aligned center, call span is 2. Why we are using call span 2 is like see the output so that you can understand. See how many rows are there? 1 row, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Each row consisting of maximum how many fields? First name is first row, first column. Again, a text field. First row, second column. So in the first row, how many columns are there? First name is one column. Second column is text field. So maximum, I am using 2 columns for every row, maximum. So that's why I am making this title with a call the span. The column span merging as equal to 2. Equal to 2, right? So call span equal to 2. Fill the details over here. The fill details for account, just a title. This column align as TD first, second, first row. This is a heading TH. This is the first row. First row, we are having 2 columns. First column is what? First name. TD align center, first name. What is in the second column? Align center, input. Type equal to what? Text name, F name, because for the references, for later, when you are connecting the same registration page with the database, to make the link references, I am using name attribute, name equal to F name. What is the size of the text field? Means how many number of characters can be added in the first name is maximum 15. If you want, you can increase also. If you want, you can reduce also. Second row, this is a last name. Same, type equal to text, name equal to LM, size is 15. Similarly, the third row. Third row, 2 columns, one is gender, type equal to radio. As I said, you type equal to radio when you are adding that. We are adding here 2 radio buttons of same type. That's why same type means what? The name equal to G here. Here also be the name is G. Because for referring, maybe they can select not both. Only they can select male or female. That's why in this column, we are going to using input type equal to radio, name equal to G, value equal to male. Same input type equal to radio, name equal to G, value equal to female. Both are selecting only at once. So both are belongs to only one gender. So that's why both the names refers with only G, right? So maybe they will select male, maybe they will select female. The third, again, next row talks about date of birth. How the date of birth? Just type equal to date means it will display as a calendar. Type equal to date. And the next row talks about username. So type equal to text. And the size is 15. Similarly, password. Next row. Type equal to password. Next, confirm password. Type equal to password. Now, next is address. So, how much of text area sizes is required is 6 rows. We have a tag called as text area. Rows equal to 6, you can add it over here. So, like this, you can add. Next row, the postal code. That is type equal to text. The maximum length of the postal code. What is the PIN number? Postal code for Tirupati. 517-102 for Rangampet, 517-502 for this Tirupati, 502-501 like this. And next row talks about email. So type equal to email. Automatically take type equal to email validation. Next is reset button. So type equal to reset, value equal to this. And next is type equal to type, submit, and value is submit over there. So end of the rows, end of the table, end of the division, end of the body, end of the history. So this is how the registration page looks like. So what we are doing for this registration page, where the registration belongs to, registration page comes under which frame? Under the third frame. So we need to be link that open the frame 3. Open frame 3. In this frame 3, where we have in this frame 3, here create an account. Here create an account is there. Agree? Now in this, when I am clicking create an account, where I kept the registration.html, I kept it in my folder. That path you need to mention here. That is href equal to anchor tag href equal to local disk e kkb wt so on so sv16 demos week 1 registration.html. This is the page when I click this. And coming to the main.html. So this is the main.html, right? Agree? So this is the main.html. So when I click here, here is a create an account. When I'm clicking this create an account, it will open registration page. Like this, everything in a proper way, you please try to connect where I'm adding, for which frame I'm going to designing this one. In that frame, you need to be set the path. Clearly, with the patience, you please follow the things what I have just discussed with you. So in this week one, we have discussed the home page, catalog page. Catalog page look like this. And we have discussed the registration page as well.